he will be the German messiah that will take all reggae boys to the next World Cup. Frankly, I think reggae boys need something more than a messiah, but that's besides the point. Winifred Schaefer. He is the one that is going to take us to the next realistic opportunity of the World Cup in Russia. But guys, did he even merit a contract? And I give you another point. Did he merit another contract? And did the reggae boys even merit a coach?
Come on.
Deadly just.
Don't be mean to the guys.
They're pretty bad though. Like, I'm serious. I was 8 when they were trying to go to the World Cup in 1998. And what the hell happened though? Where have they been since then?
It's been a long, rough road, but...
And Winnie isn't going to get us there.
Winnie's
not going to get us there. In fact, you know, I'm going to start by saying that he has had some success at the international and club level with Cameroon and popular Asian club Al Ahly. So it's a little difficult to argue against his resume, or is it though? Because, no, it actually isn't.
Wait, sir, are you for or against?
But I'm against. I'm obviously against the German messiah or whatever you call him. First of all, we walk around telling people this lie that he qualified Cameroon to the World Cup.
Nobody said that. He actually did not.
In fact, he joined Cameroon at the very end of their World Cup campaign. And you know what he has done in his 3 or 4 years there? He has won 8 games, Squeezy. A grand total of 8 games in over 3 years.
And
let us not forget also how that all ended with him and the Cameroon FA. Yeah, the ministry actually chased him out of Cameroon, pointing to gross misconduct and a poor performance. His own technical director, a fellow named Robert Kafu, or whatever his name is, actually said Schaefer is pretty much impossible to work with. Sounds about familiar, doesn't it? Is this what we want, though?
But reggae boys are kind of impossible to work with, and we've kept them, so you know.
By the way,
2 years as a coach, as a player, Bundesliga titles, German Cup titles. Listen, Winifred Schaefer is a winner.
Let's not underestimate
his role in that Cameroon team. He led them to the African Nations Cup,
sir.
And a year later, he led them to second.
Sir, you could have led that Cameroon team to the African Cup of Nations. They were that good. And by the way, his misdemeanors did not end there. His misdemeanors didn't end there, sir.
Sit here and pretend that a team coaches itself and that talent alone is enough to do it.
All I'm saying is, sir, he seems to be a lot of trouble, and I'm not sure he's worth it. The Thailand FA, sir, he had a big public spot with the Thailand FA. He had broke a contract with a club in Thailand to join the Reggae Boys. I mean, I'm just saying he's a lot of trouble. I'm not quite sure he's worth the trouble.
You guys are dealing with the elephant in the room, though. This is the Reggae Boys that he is coaching.
Listen.
I need someone to tell me that he is going to take them to the World Cup.
You know who?
Reggae Boys.
Schaefer's ideas.
Mm-hmm.
His ability to spot talent and his ability
Tuffy.
To work with a
he spotted Tuffy. That's not...
Anyway. Sir, that was smart. That was smart.
You know what, sir? Listen to me.
Listen, hold on. His ability to work with a country with limited infrastructure as ours, the bad pitches, as they are in Cameroon, that's an obvious advantage for Jamaica.
But he didn't do too well for Cameroon. That's what I'm saying. He won 8 of 20, almost 30 games. But listen, I'm from the country. I'm a countryman. Proud countryman.
Oh, Lord.
And my grandmother used to always tell me, see, donkey say, the world no level.
Now, please tell me what you're saying.
I blame Theodore Whitmore for sitting down and becoming a puppet for Captain Berlin.
And the rest of the JFF.
But you know what? Theodore Whitmore deserves that money. Whatever money Schaefer is getting, Whitmore deserves it. And Theodore Whitmore, if there wasn't any interference from the captain, you know, like forcing him to go to England and bringing a bunch of subpar English players to come and disrupt a team that he had worked with and built for 4 years, we probably would have been on our way to Rio right now.
Schaefer doesn't warrant his contract because Theodore Whitmore didn't have the balls to stand up.
Listen.
Like, seriously?
The book stops with you.
Captain Burr is a very intimidating fellow, you know, right? Very intimidating fellow. You can't ask a man to patch up his team at the very last minute and expect them to get results. He's Theodore Whitmore, not final Theodore point. Of Nazareth. That's my final point. There's nothing more to say. Winnie, give Theodore the money. It's not your money. Leave Tapper money alone.
What's your final point? Please tell me something better.
Listen. Schaefer, he's motivated. He's intelligent. We've heard the way that...
You're trying to say Whitmore is dumb?
No, I didn't say that.
Oh, okay. Let's get into it.
He didn't go there. You did.
But tactically, I believe he's very astute. And he's the man for the job.
My final point is, Schaefer has shown very little, has shown very little in his international career to warrant a second chance, or another chance, an extended chance with the Reggae Boys.
I like how we haven't said that the team hasn't shown that they even deserve to be at.
They had a very good team before the captain. They had a very good team before the captain, okay. You know, put his hand
all
in the pot.
All right, guys. All right, we're wrapping it up. Okay, we're going into our final session. These guys are going to whip out their crystal balls and they're going to give us their sports predictions for this year.
Sure. Let me start off.
Yeah, all right. This is going to be nice.
Let's see what we have here. Jamaica's Reggae Boys will beat France 2-1 in their final. Hold on, I'm getting a different message. I'm going to break the hearts of lots of Jamaican fans here. Brazil will not win the World Cup in their home country.
Okay. I'm going to have to agree with Mugi on that one. And I'm a bit concerned. It's the second time in one show. But yeah, I think Brazil will get at least to the quarterfinals. I just don't think they have the team to do it under severe pressure in their home country. There are a lot of teams that I think better suited for going into the World Cup. You look at Germany, Spain, those are easy to say. Italy are traditional contenders at this level. And I think fans are beginning to find their form and they have the players and the pieces to create some upsets and probably go on to win the World Cup.
They certainly do. And I know a lot of people are looking towards Neymar. He's an exceptional talent. But the World Cup can be a funny tournament. And as we've seen with other superstars, it doesn't always pan out how we all expect it.
Put your money on Argentina. They are going to win this World Cup for sure. If they can sort out that left midfield situation, I really don't think that Di Maria should be playing in left midfield. Put him at a more advanced role.
Okay, guys. They could win. I'm going to advise you to, you know, take what are you guys calling yourself?
Well, I'm the guru. He's just crazy.
You guys are calling yourself prophets these days. Now, anybody that calls himself a prophet, it's not somebody you should be listening to. So you may want to take everything with a grain of salt and probably not put any sort of, you know, money on it. Why? Because I will not be held responsible for any bets that you guys lose because of these guys.
Neither will I.
Like, keep in mind that they're calling themselves prophets. Guys, that's it for our show. Thank you so much for joining us on End to End. And until next time, leave us your comments. #GLNRN2N.